Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, I don't think that the minister who just spoke really knows what accountability is in the context of this bill, because what I heard from him was a speech about the functions of ministers and not about their accountability at all. In fact, this bill is fatally flawed as far as accountability and many other aspects of it are concerned. Section 18, as agreed by the Select Committee, makes it clear that topics are to be prescribed by regulation and that that will be not an independent method of selecting topics for reporting. There is no point, Mr. Chairman, in having a Section 14 which imposes a duty on the Secretary and the Government statistician to report and act independently, when that is not the case as far as the selection of topics by ministers are concerned. And there's no point in having a section in 15 imposing a duty on the Secretary and on the Government statistician to report fairly and accurately when that is also not something that is required of the minister in setting the regulations to determine what the topics are. So the truth is that it is purely and completely a function of the ministers as to what topics are to be reported on. And that is not independence, and that is not accountability. So New Zealand First cannot support the bill for that reason, not because we just want to oppose things, as Scott Simpson says. These are good and substantial reasons for opposing the bill, and New Zealand First prefers Eugenie Sage's SOP instead. Section 18 says the ministers may cause regulations to be made prescribing topics for both synthesis reports and domain reports, and that means they can choose what they feel should be reported on, and they can also choose that something will not be reported on, presumably if that wouldn't be convenient for the government. And Mr. Chairman, there's only a little guidance given in subsection 2 about how the topics are to be selected, and they are requirements for a pressure topic or an impact topic which has to reflect significant areas, resources or people, and secondly, there is a requirement about measurability. And the only other limitation is in subsection 3, which is the requirement to consult. And Mr. Ducey thought that that meant that that created independence and accountability as far as ministers are concerned, but of course it doesn't. A duty to consult is just that, to hear what others have to say and to take it into account. It doesn't mean that the ministers can't still choose what to report and what not to report on. So it doesn't go nearly far enough. So in the end, the section reserves full power to the ministers to control environmental reporting in New Zealand with virtually no checks and balances, nor any genuine oversight, nor any genuine transparency, nor any real accountability for the reasons that I gave. And Mr. Chairman, the ministers as a result will have virtual carte blanche to do as they wish as far as environmental reporting is concerned in New Zealand, and they will have massive manoeuvring room in deciding that, and they will have huge opportunities for manipulation, political manipulation as far as that is concerned. And most of all, they will have the power to actually prevent reporting on topics which it is not convenient for the government to have reports on. Mr. Chairman, there are two good alternatives to what is proposed in the bill. And one is that there could be a schedule in the Act every 3 years to determine what the topics should be. And if it's only done every 3 years, that is not an excessive imposition on the Parliament. And that's actually democracy. It means the members in this House would have the opportunity to say what the topic should be. That would be debated in public, and the public would therefore get a good grip on what was happening. But that's not going to be the case under this bill. And the other alternative, Mr. Chairman, the other alternative, Mr. Chairman.
Dennis O'Rourke.
The other alternative is Eugenie Sage's SOP, which provides that jointly the Secretary responsible for the Environment Act and the government statistician would determine what the topics would be. That is independence. That is a system that doesn't involve ministers at all and excludes the possibility of political interference. That is what independence means, not what some of the members on the other side of the House think it means. Mr. Chairman, the only other thing I wanted to mention about this part was section 16, because it has not been sufficiently altered by the committee, indeed not really altered at all. It prevents the Official Information Act from operating as intended by limiting access to what is called untested information. So officials will be able to withhold information which they prefer to avoid be put out into the public arena. Members of the public will not be able to access this so-called untested information, and Mr. Chairman, they should be entitled to do so. And it is arrogant for the government to say to the public of New Zealand, they shouldn't have that access to that information because it's untested. Well, it's over, in my view, to the people of New Zealand to decide what they believe is valid and valuable and worthwhile information, whether it is tested or not. Why should it matter whether it is tested or not? The public should still have access to it. It is for them to decide whether it is of value and not for some official to do so. Nowhere else, I believe, in similar legislation is an excuse like that given for excluding the operation of the Official Information Act. After all, it's harmless statistical information. It's not as though it's dangerous information. So what harm is there in allowing that information to be given? Mr. Chairman, in the end, this bill just fails. It fails completely, not only because it behaves with arrogance towards the New Zealand public by not giving them information which they should be able to access, but it fails because it doesn't ensure that reporting is independent. And the only way it can be independent is if ministers don't, in the end, determine what topics are to be reported on, or indeed are not to be reported on. So either of the two alternatives which I gave would be satisfactory, and I believe would earn the support of every party in this House. We are not just opposing this bill because that's our job. We are opposing it for good and substantial reasons. And if the government was to move on this in the way that I and others have suggested, it would earn full support right across the House, because we all want to see a high standard of environmental reporting that can only be achieved without political interference, with independence and with genuine accountability. This bill just doesn't measure up.